Junction. I didn't really know where I was going, so I was dawdling at Dalston Junction. And you must never dawdle at Dalston Junction, Scotland, because if you dawdle at Dalston Junction, one of two things is going to happen. You're either going to be shot in the face, or you're going to have a satirical anti-capitalist graffiti mural sprayed on you by a white middle-class art school dropout. And which one of those two things happens depends on which way the tide of gentrification is flowing that week. So I was at Dalston Junction, I was dawdling, I was holding up the traffic, and a black guy pulled up alongside me in a car, and he wound down the window, and he shouted at me in a jaunty, encouraging, not unfriendly sort of way. He shouted, "Come on, move your ass, nigger." Now, as a white, middle-class liberal, I have terrible anxieties about the use of that word. And the Football Association, for example, have struggled terribly with that word in recent years. As they have, to be fair, with all words. Unless they're a synonym for the phrase, "Ah, the lad's done well." Race is a hot potato in football, ongoing one. And Reg Hunter, who is a black comedian, he got in trouble for using the N-word at a football do. And David Burstein, the then head of the FA, he said the word was unacceptable, irrespective of context. And I don't completely understand the genuine anxiety behind the thinking, but far be it from me to take issue with a footballer's grasp of semantics. But can you have a context-free word? Can you have a word the meaning of which has no relationship with the meaning of the words around it? Isn't that just what language is? I don't know. Can you have a context-free word? If you call a tree a twat in a forest, and there's no one there from the FA to adjudicate, how do you know if that's offensive? If you shout tits at a shrub in a cellar, is that wrong? If Ricky Gervais shouts mong in a forest over and over again, and there's no Americans there to tell him he's a genius, is that then offensive? I don't know. Can you have a context-free word? And if you can have a context-free word, what does that say about my experience of a black man calling me the N-word in an apparently friendly way in multicultural Dalston? Was it an insult? Was it a compliment? Was it a case of mistaken identity? I've got no idea whatsoever. I don't understand what's going on. If you want certainties, you have to go and see Roy Chubby Brown in his new touring show, An Evening of Certainty. The advertising strapline, "Leave the same as you arrived, only more so." I don't know. But what I say to footballers is this: footballers, do not attempt to advise writers and artists on the way that words and sounds become couriers for nuanced meaning. And we won't attempt to advise you on how best to change ends at half-time with a drunk teenager in a hotel penthouse. Right, now this is exactly the sort of thing that I'm talking about. There was laughs, wasn't there? Applause and some anxious sort of booing over there. And I think I know what's going on. The audience generally here, they've thought, we understand the thrust of this broadly. He's asking questions about the relative merits of misogyny and racism in football culture. We understand there's a broadly liberal thrust to the joke, but we're uncomfortable, Stu, about the violence of the imagery contained within it. And I understand that, and I'm very alert to taste issues in stand-up. I've been trying to think how best to deal with taste issues in stand-up. And to that end, I've been watching Jimmy Carr on Channel 4's 10 o'clock live, and I know now if you've got a joke, you're not sure about the taste implications that it throws up. When you've said it, at the end, you just go... That's the same as having thought about it.